Hi and welcome. My name's Crash. This is a game called Firewatch. It's been in my Steam inventory for quite some time. I haven't yet played it. But hopefully it will make a nice... Oh, I can move the screen backwards and forwards, up and down. Hopefully it'll make a nice playthrough. I believe it's not terribly long. But anyway, without further ado, let's start the game.
Boulder, Colorado, 1975. You see Julia. She's about your age, late 20s, laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. You are drunk. You're pretty. You're pretty, she says, coolly. You're not your future hangover. What? You reply, confused. Someone should buy you a cheeseburger, she says. She flags down a waiter and 1 week later you are Julia's boyfriend.
I appear to be in a lift. Garage, by the looks of it. Fire extinguisher.
You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. You move in. You share an apartment near the school, with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Julia wants to get a dog. There's a scruffy, undersized beagle. Julia is in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There is also an intermediate but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. Bucket's a good dog, and a week later you've totally forgotten about the other one. Julia loves him. You love him too. 1979. You talk out on the deck. It's late summer, 9:30 p.m. and the heat still radiates off the high desert. What do you think about kids? She asks. Kids, they're not very smart, or good at much. I'm saying if you and I have some, a couple of little idiots one day, why rush? She looks away. Out towards the mountains. We have plenty of time, right? Speak for yourself, mister. You tell her she has the body of an undergrad. My ovaries didn't get the memo, she says, laughing it off. Okay, one day, she says. 6 months later you get engaged lying in bed on a Sunday morning.
Hey, where's my backpack gone? Oh, I presume I'm wearing it. Yeah, why not? Through Fair Trailhead. Do not forget to check in. Learn to live with the bears. We're obviously at a place called Two Forks. No fireworks. Not recommended for inexperienced hikers. Okay, well, I don't even know where I'm going. Looks very pleasant.
1980. It's a Thursday night and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call. You're worried and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you have gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets.
Oh, what should I do? Should I ignore her or get mad with her? I don't really want to do either. I won't give her a cuddle. Let's ignore her for a minute.
You don't touch each other all night. The next day you feel guilty for being so angry and ask her about her evening. She says it was great. You hold onto a tiny pill of resentment.
I'll make some coffee and go to work.
1981. Julia likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you.
Yeah, okay. I've got shirts on. And a belt. And a pair of feet. Cool. I just jumped down from there. Okay. Looks like the sun's going down to me. Beautiful countryside. What's this? Two Forks, straight on. Oh, it's bright, that sun.
1982.
During the summers, you and Julia enjoy walking Bucket at night.
There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Bucket gets kicked. Julia yells. She gets flustered and has trouble speaking when she is stressed. You confront the attacker.
I'm gonna scare him away.
You reach into your pocket like you have a gun and threaten to kill him. You manage to scare all three of you. He runs away. Julia asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say okay. You don't want to go that way either. From then on you walk by the river. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job, associate department chair. She wants to move.
Oh, I don't want to stop her career.
You ask her if she'll commute back and forth. You don't want to move to Connecticut. She says that'll be hard, but she will do it if you don't want to move. You tell her not to pass it up, if it's what she wants. She agrees. She flies back to Boulder 3 times each semester, 1985. Julia is sent home from Yale on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research.
That doesn't sound
She
good.
Didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairwell.
I think we should definitely talk.
After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they are worried that Julia might be suffering from early onset of dementia.
I have a journal. Yeah. I think that's best left closed.
Bucket gets older. Julia comments that it's kind of nice because he gets in less trouble around the house. 1987. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember thing in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over, for no particular reason, and has to be brought home by the police. She is devastated. Some days you get the Julia that calls you a dope and your unborn children little idiots. Other days you get a stranger.
That's not good.
You tell her family, they're crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. 1988. You spend 4 days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the two weekly visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else. Somewhere with 24-hour care. A home. It sits with you for a couple of months.
He needs help. I presume I go this way. So this is obviously background story being filled in. He's married to a lady called Julia, who's got dementia at the early age of 41.
Her family agrees with your decision. You find a fantastic place in Boulder and move her there. You see her every day. You go out to the bar with your old friends. It's not the same. You get the feeling that every wife tells her husband, if you put me in a home like Henry did, I will cut your balls off. Julia's sister Susan moves to Boulder to be close to her. She visits every day. You go with her some of the time. Susan buys you an old typewriter and urges you to use it if you won't see a therapist. You won't. Months go by. Bucket dies. Julia doesn't remember him when you tell her. Sometimes it takes her a minute to lock in on you. In the back of your mind you believe it's because you see her less and less. And seeing her less and less makes her forget you more.
Sounds like a good idea. A job.
You take it.
So I've taken it. Enter the lookout tower. Yeah, we'll do in a sec. I'll have a look around first. Well, that was a different intro to a game, I must admit. It does look rather nice. Is there anything here other than the tower? Doesn't look like it. Okay, let's go up the tower. Looks like some fencing over there. An outhouse there. Oh, there's another tower. Thoroughfare lookout. Can't see anywhere else in eyesight. And pass the door right open. Turn on the power. Okay, how do I turn on the power? Map table. Radio, supplies, wood stove, some reading material. Aha! Generator switch.
Hello, Two Forks Tower. Two Forks Tower, this is Thoroughfare Tower. Come in.
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine. Then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
Well, that's not the button. How do I reply?
You're just gonna wait me out on this? Ugh, fine. But I'm gonna take a second here and have a guess about you. Let's see. I don't know anything about you. I say you got fired from your job and have finally decided to write your novel. That's the sort of bullshit reason you'll find a man out in the woods.
Good night.
Welcome to the job.
Day one.
Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
Hey, sorry, guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, 14 hours of sleep? Whew.
Yeah, Jesus, I guess it's, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it, that hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
Which way's west?
Are those fucking fireworks?
And to use the compass. West, so it's out this way then.
I need you to confirm. Do you see them?
Yeah, I see them. How do I reply?
Are you seeing this?
Yeah, but how do I reply?
Henry?
Oh, how do I reply? Hat. Thank you.
Whoa. That's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is 2 days away. Go down there and set them straight. Do you think you can handle that?
Do I write him a ticket?
Easy there, Dirty Harry.
Well?
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually bad for all of them.
Secure.
Shut up.
Okay. Don't take my backpack with me, obviously, then. Don't need to... No. Okay, open the door. Oh, I've grabbed it anyway. Oh! And we're off. Right, N to use the compass. So that's west over there. So I've got to head that way. Mind my head. Could do with a little more instruction on how to use the controls. So it's this way. M to read map. Okay. Find rope catch in cash box 306. So I need to head northeast then, really. Cache 306 is down the road. Okay. Where's the road? This must be it. Well, I presume it's it. Radio. Now, where am I on the map? So I've got to turn left down here. I can hear the fireworks going off. So have I got to get this rope first? Oh, I need to climb down. Right, okay. But it's going in the opposite direction. Is one of these games I'm going to be checking my map on a regular basis. So what's that red square? I guess we'll find out. I presume I'm going the right way. Thought it best to stay on the path and not get too lost. Right, there's something over there.
I take it you fell prey to the Forest Service's big recruiting effort when it comes to, you know, how the hell you ended up out here.
I saw the job in the paper and figured, you know, what the heck.
No ties and no life. Better go spend what's left of it in utter loneliness.
Something like that?
Yeah, thanks to last summer, the bump in Forest Service budget actually allowed for us to advertise for the job. Glad it worked.
What happened last summer that accounted for this, windfall?
Jeez. I mean, the federal government almost let Yellowstone National Park burn to the ground? Ring a bell?
How do I?
But hey, I got a 30 cents an hour raise because we can't have another fiasco. If the goddamn park can burn down again.
Map, copy information, okay. Map updated. So what have we got in here? A pine cone, some books, Jane Eyre. Not really interested. Didn't mean to throw it down like that. Toilet paper. It's definitely toilet paper. But I don't see a rope. So how do I... This is supply box 306, cache 306, is it? No, it's not. It's the wrong supply cache. I've gone completely the wrong way. Okay, right. Close. Back we go then. So, I want to head, presuming that north is up, I want to head north-west. In that general direction, right, okay. Doing a very good job of being a fire warden so far. I can't even find my way to the people letting off the fireworks. There you go. Right, so I'm trying to cut through, save some time, to make up lost time, but we'll see. There's the tower, so stop walking a minute. Right, okay. Over in this direction then. Basically, I've got to turn left. I'll turn west now. Not very, never been very good at orienteering with a compass. Not something I've spent a lot, well, any time doing, to be honest with you. Four, wasn't it? Right, copy the map information down. Map updated. What's this say? Ron. Hey man. Guy couldn't take it, so I locked up this lockout. Locked up his lockout and put some stuff in the box. Found one of those bars you liked hiking into the park. But let's get fucked when I'm back. Dave. Nice. Rope. It's definitely a rope. He won't mind if I pick up his granola bar. Okay. Still don't know how to initiate dialogue with Delilah. Ah, what was that?
Hey, I found a note to a guy named Ron from some guy Dave.
That's probably Dave Gaskell. He's completely nuts.
Is that right?
Harmless, but yeah. One of those, you know, fall off the grid and eat ants for a week type. Totally fucking cuckoo. Which is kind of what the job attracts.
Okay. So I've got to head west now, towards the fireworks. Deal with whoever's are to juggle and toggle jogging mode. Okay. I'm jogging. Oh, there's the fireworks. Okie dokes. Attach rope to hook. Excuse me. Come on, let's rappel down then.
Snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
Oh, the sun's going down. Oh, it's coming through the trees. So where's these farts? Come on. Still heading west. Let's jog a bit more then. I think I just ran the other side of these trees over here, this hill. Report Meadow.
I'm staring at the big outcropping down here, but I'm not quite sure where to look for our pyrotechnicians.
Maybe keep heading west toward the lake.
Oh, look, they decided to have a campfire, too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't take into account just plain stupid, does it?
They left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
No, I don't want to pick them up. Oh.
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
investigate them.
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans. They threw them all over hell.
Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, sure am.
Ugh, people are just the worst, aren't they?
They're not great, no. Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
Okay. Finish your music. I mean, why would you come out to a place like that to play music? Sorry, you come out to a place like that to enjoy the peace and quiet.
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
There are, panties.
There are what?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
Hmm. Ah, here we are. Where's that music coming from there? Oh, there. Oh, I see, now I see it.
Cool stereo!
Whoa, hey, put that down! Seriously, it was expensive!
Fucking cool it with the fireworks!
Please just put it down, we won't light anymore!
Well, I'll put it down, okay.
You guys are setting up bottle rockets out here, okay?
How? Because you're hiding in the bushes and spying on us?
Give him a break, Lily. He probably hasn't seen boobs in 20 years.
He's probably still a virgin.
Why do guys think it's all right to just stare at girls?
Hey, just so you're aware, I confiscated your fireworks.
Our fireworks? What?
Yeah.
Also, setting off fireworks out here isn't just stupid, it's illegal.
Yeah, so is stealing, asshole. That's so fucking bogus.
What language.
You're gonna pay for that.
Can we just... Yeah. Yeah, they are drunk.
You're gross.
You're just some sad man out in the woods.
Really? How do I switch it off? Oh, I'll just put it back.
Hey, that go okay?
I hope they drown.
Yow!
I don't think anyone would mourn a couple of future arsonists.
Just gonna go ahead and not log that as a threat?
Thanks.
But seriously, though, thanks for dealing with it.
Okay. Alright, we've got to get back to the tower then. So... where are we exactly on the map? Over there. Oh, I didn't realize. Okay, so if we go along Thunder Canyon, actually we want to go the other way, don't we? Yes, we want to go this way. No, can't go through there. Can I get up over here? Yes. Right, I'm going back the way I came. Found a campsite. Blocked trail clear. Well, if you give me the option, I will do, but. Over it. Well, let's go around it. That's if I can. This is where I came in. So, right, here's the path, hopefully. Yes, there's the pants. Or panties, as he called them. And the bra. Well, I must admit, my first impressions. Are pretty good, actually. I don't know, it's taken me a little while to figure out the controls. I mean, they're fairly obvious, but it's still, you know, the reporting on the radio was a little bit difficult. God, there's loads of cans. They must be drunk. Well, we know they're drunk. Any full ones now? Right, so where are we exactly? We're on our way back. Good. So let's go for a jog. Report Meadow.
It is a hell of a nice camping spot down here by the lake.
I haven't been down there in years, but yeah, Jonesy Lake area is perfect.
Hey, I'm back near that big rock outcropping, but not sure how to get back.
I'd head west, back towards the lake, and then turn north towards the canyon.
Oh, that's the complete opposite way to where I'm going. Of course, there's no rope, is there? The rope broke. Well, guys, I have no idea how long I've been recording this. I was hoping to find my way back to Two Forks Lookout before I quit the episode, but I think I'm going to call it a day on this episode here. I hope you enjoyed. We'll carry on in episode 2 for next time, but until then, do take care.